Hello friends, this is Janvi Sangoi from Viva Institute of Technology. Today I'll be explaining you the banker's algorithm. This topic is from operating system. So we will be studying the theory of a banker's algorithm and we will see one problem on the banker's algorithm. Banker's algorithm is basically a resource allocation algorithm. Meaning, whenever the resource has been allocated, this algorithm is used. It is used to avoid the deadlock. So, it is also called as the deadlock avoidance algorithm. Now, we will see why it is called as a banker's algorithm. It is called so because it is used in the banking system to check whether the loan can be sanctioned to a person or not. For example, we will take a scenario of a bank. Suppose there are n number of account holders in a bank and total sum of their money is m. And if some person x applies for a loan, then the bank first subtracts the loan amount from the total money that bank has, and if the remaining amount is greater than that m, then only the loan is sanctioned. Why it is done? It is done because if all the account holders come to withdraw their money, then the bank can easily do it. In other words, what bank is doing, bank would never allocate its money in such a way that it can no longer satisfy the needs of all its customers, their own customers. So bank would try to be in a safe state always. Now when we will see this algorithm in detail, we will find that there are four data structures which are used: allocation, max available and need matrix. What do you mean by allocation? Allocation is nothing but the number of resources of each type currently allocated to each process. What is the max? It is maximum demand of each process in the system. Available indicates the number of available resources of each type, and the need matrix is remaining resource needed of each process. So these are the four data structures, and there are two parts in this algorithm: the safety algorithm and request algorithm. So we will see the safety and request algorithm. First one is the safety algorithm. It finds out if the system is in the safe state. So whenever we are running the safety algorithm, there are four steps which we need to carry. These steps we will see in detail whenever we are solving the problem. So we have to keep in mind that safety algorithm is that time used whenever we need to find if the system is in the safe state. The second is the request algorithm. Now the request algorithm has these three steps which are performed whenever the resource request is made, then only this will be performed. That too we will see in the detail whenever we are solving the problem. Now let us move to the problem. So here, this is the problem based on the banker's algorithm. You can see there are the processes P0 to P4. So basically there are five processes. And how many resources are there? Three, A, B and C. Their allocation, maximum and available data structure is given over here. So how we are reading? P0 has 0, 1, 0 allocation, maximum. How many we can give? 753 to P0. Likewise for P1 it is 200 and 322 and so on till P4. Now the available resources are: for A we have 3 instances, B has 3 and C has 2. Whenever we need to solve the problem in banker's algorithm, we need to find the need matrix. You can see here which the data structure which we have discussed, allocation, maximum and available, you can see over here. Now we need to find the need matrix, that is your step one. So step one is to find the need matrix. How it is calculated? Need is equal to maximum minus allocation. So this is your given problem. So you have to subtract allocation from maximum. So for P0, how it will be? 753 minus 010. The answer you will get as 743. For P1 it will be 3 minus 2, that is 1. 2 minus 0 is 2 and 2 minus 0 is 2. Likewise, we have to calculate till P4. So the new need matrix we are getting here. Next is, we have to find whether the system is in the safe state. If yes, then what is the safe sequence of that? So we have to apply the safety algorithm on the given system. So here it is the steps which we have seen. There are 4 steps. We will go stepwise in this. The step 1 in the safety algorithm says that work should be equal to available and finish of I is equal to false for all I is equal to 0 till n minus 1. Now here you can see m is equal to 3, that is the resources are 3. N is equal to 5, that is the processes are 5. Work is equal to available. Now available has the values as 3, 3 and 2. So work is equal to 3, 3 and 2. And all the finishes is set as false. So there are 5 processes. We have to start with the 0, that's why 0. And it is n minus 1, which is 5 minus 1, which is 4. So all are made false. Now the next step says that find an I such that both finish of I is equal to false and need will be less than or equal to work. So for I is equal to 0, we will go in the ascending order, I is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, likewise. So for I is equal to 0, need matrix for 0, process 0 is 7, 4, 3. And finish of 0, we can see here it is false. So we need to check need and work. So if we are comparing need of P0 and the work matrix, then we will see that it is need is greater. What we want is work should be always greater than the need. So P0, process P0 must have wait now. Now, next one is I1. So this is the step 2. So I1, if you see, the need of process P1 is 1, 2, 2. Finish of 1 is false. Already we have said that as a false. So need and work will be compared. This is satisfied. So P1 must be in the safe sequence. So first P1 will be kept. Then whenever it comes as a true, what we have to do, work is equal to work plus allocation. So we need to recalculate work. Finish of I should be made true. And then we have to again repeat the step 2. So if you see, we are recalculating work. So work is equal to work plus allocation and we are getting the value as 532. And the finish will be set as true. So P1 will be the first process in the sequence. Next we will go to I is equal to 2. So need of 2 is equal to 600. Finish of 2 is false. And now we will again check this. This is coming as false. That's why P2 must wait now. Then we will go for I is equal to 3. If we see here, need of 3 is 011. Now if you compare here, this is coming as true. So next is P3 will be in the safe sequence. So after P1, there will be P3. Work will be recalculated and finish will be set as true. Next we will go for I is equal to 4. Here also it is satisfied. So this is coming as true. So after that, P3, P4 will be kept. Whenever it is coming true, what we have to do, recalculate the work. Work is now 745 and this P4 is made as true. Next, all we have seen, I is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. But only 1, then 3 and 4 has satisfied. The next 2 are remaining, which are they? P0 and P2. So what we will do is, we will go for I is equal to 0. So this step we have to repeat. Now need of 0 is as it is 743. If you compare this steps, then the need is same. Work is 745 because we have we are taking the recalculated value. Earlier it was 332, that's why it is not coming true. Now it is satisfying. So after P4, what we will do? P0 will be kept in the sequence. Again, the recalculation will be done and work we will get as 755, and P0 will be set to true. Remaining is only 2. Here you can see only 2 is remaining. So for I is equal to 2, need is 600, work is 755 now. That's why this is coming true. So now this P2 will be kept in the sequence. So work will be recalculated. So work is, final work is 10, 5 and 7, and all are true. If you see the step 4 says that if all are true, then the system is in the safe state. So your system will be in the safe state. Now next is, what will be the sequence? Sequences P1, P3, P4, P0 and P2. So however they are satisfying the condition, they are kept in the sequence. So this is the new sequence which we are getting. Now there is another algorithm also, which is the resource request algorithm. Now whenever certain process is requesting the resources, then this algorithm will be run in order to check whether the resources can be allocated to that process or not. Now here the question is given that P1 is requesting additional 1 instances of a A and 2 instances of C, and B that does not that doesn't want B, resource B. So request of 1, that is request of process 1, is 102. Now here there are 3 steps which we have to perform. First is request of I should be less than or equal to need. Then we have to go to 2, where the comparison between request and available will be done. Again, if it is true, then we have to do all these 3 changes. We have to change 3 data structures: available, allocation, or and need of the requesting process. So if you see, request of 1 is 102 and need is 122. This is satisfied. So we are moving to the second step. Request and available will be checked. So 102 and 332. So step 2 also satisfied. So we are moving to step 3 now. Now in step 3, we have to recalculate the value of available, allocation and need. So after calculating these values, we are getting some new values for allocation, need and available for P1. So these are the new values. Now after giving the resources, next we have to check whether the system is in the safe state. Again we have to run the safety algorithm on the given values. So we will be running the safety algorithm on this value. Again those steps will be carried out. So there will be total 4 steps like we have seen. So the 4 steps will be carried out and then the safe sequence can be found. So here, after solving this, after giving the resources to process P1, the system is in the safe state. And what is the sequence? The sequence is P1, P3, P4, P0 and P2. This way we have to solve the banker's algorithm example. So problem is explained to you. Thank you.